Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through Turing test, guys. So from the name itself, we can say Turing is the guy name who proposed or who thought of this test. So in 1950, Alan Turing proposed a Turing test. So that is what we are discussing now. Don't worry guys, it's really simple and easy. So the main objective or goal of this Turing test is to decide if there are if the robo or the artificial intelligent device is acting like a human or not, or whether it is giving the answers as a human or not. So that is the main goal of this test, guys. So the main goal of the test is to say whether the machine is artificially intelligent or not. Okay, so the test will be in this way, guys. So basically, you will be in another room, you are here, and there will be a person and there will be a robo, guys. Okay, so here this will be operated by a person and this is you. Fine. So you will be asking a question. What is your name? Like this. Hi, are you a computer? So you are asking a question like that. So the first person gives that no, my name is Mary. So it gave the answer in that way. Whereas the lower one gave, that's nothing but our robo gave, are you kidding? I'm Hal. So this is also thinking and giving the answer. So can you judge which is the artificial intelligence device or both are the humans? So if you cannot judge that this is a artificial intelligent robo or anything, then this passed the Turing test and this device, we can say that it is an artificially intelligent device. Okay, so let us go through the points. So here I asked, hi, are you a computer? No, my name is Mary. Are you kidding? I am Hal. So in that way, it gave the result, guys. So can you judge which is the robo? No, we cannot judge it. So even there will be few guys who will be just talking in that way. Are you kidding? They will be having many, many common faces which they will be using. Fine, so that's the reason why we cannot judge them directly. Okay, so the user, the guy who is testing, will ask a question to the computer. That those are nothing but the intelligence system and the human. So the lower one will be calling it as intelligence system and the human. So if both give the answer and the user is not able to decide which answer is given by human and the intelligent system, then we can say that the system is that the machine is intelligent system. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through the history of artificial intelligence, guys. Like from its initial stages to now. Thank you. Thanks for watching.